السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله. الحمد لله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزِد وبارِك عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، وعلى أصحابه وأحبابه، ومن استنَّ بسُنَّته واقتفى أثره ودعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، My brothers and sisters, I have a good news for you. Are you ready to hear? Everybody is ready? الإمام البخاري رحمه الله narrated a narration from جرير ابن عبد الله البجلي رضي الله عنه. He said that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم one day he was looking to the moon. You know the moon in the middle of the month when the moon is full. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم looked around him to the companion and to the companions and said, إنكم لترون ربكم. The Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام, you will be able to see Allah, you will be able to see your Lord in the day of judgment. Is there anything prevents you from seeing the moon? If anything prevents you from seeing the moon when the moon is full in the middle of the month, anything prevents you from seeing the moon? No. So the Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام, you will be able to see Allah. Nothing will prevent you from seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way you are able to see the moon now in the Jannah. Subhanallah. Hadith reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companions, as you are able to see the sun in the middle of the day when there is no clouds, you will be able to see Allah Azza wa Jalla in the day of judgment. He said, لا تضامون. That means it will never be crowded. So those who are in the front will be able to see and those who are in the back will not be able to see. No. It's not like that. No one will need to stand on his toes to make himself taller to be able to see. No. You will be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from wherever you are in Jannah. What a beautiful prize from Allah Azza wa Jal to the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةِ. For those who did righteousness, for those who used to be righteous in their lifetime, their prize, their reward, their compensation is al-husna, al-jannah, the paradise, and something extra. What will be extra? The scholars of Islam said, the extra, you will be able to see Allah Azza wa Jalla in Jannah. Subhanallah. Some people, they deny that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is confirming that in the Quran when he said, وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة. The faces of the believers will be beautiful. ناظرة It means it will be given beauty, light. إلى ربها ناظرة. These faces will be able to see the Lord سبحانه وتعالى. The Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام in this hadith, إن استطعت ألا تغلبن على صلاة قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل غروبها فافعل. If you are able to join the prayer before sunrise and before sunset, do. When the Muslims pray in Jama'ah and the Masjid, Salat al-Fajr, be here. When the Muslims are praying Salat al-Asr before sunset, be here. Why? Because the angels of Allah, they work two shifts to record your deeds. So those who work the night shift and those who work the daytime shift, they join the believers in Salat al-Fajr. They pray with the believers. Allah said, وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. And the recitation of Salat al-Fajr, this recitation is witnessed by the angels. Two squads. And those who work at the night shift, after Salat al-Fajr, they go to Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks them, كَيْفَ تَرَكْتُمْ عِبَادِي? How did you leave my servants? So they will say to Allah, we came to them while they were praying the Asr prayer, and we left them while they were praying. So the angels testify for the believers that they joined Salat al-Fajr, they joined Salat al-Asr. And the reward is not only al-Jannah, to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every time you see Allah, you become more beautiful. Allah will increase you in beauty. And every time you see Allah Azza wa Jal, there is nothing more enjoyable in Jannah than to see Allah Azza wa Jal and to look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. If you hear that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that the most heavy prayers upon the hypocrites, Fajr prayer and Isha prayer. When you hear this, you must be in Fajr and Isha in the Masjid. Because the Prophet said, only hypocrites will see it is tough to be in Fajr prayer. It's tough to be in Isha prayer. It's not easy and busy. It's a hypocrisy. If you know the reward of praying in Jama'ah, you will never get it up while you are able not to give it up. If you are able to be in the Masjid in Isha, you will be. If you are able to be in Fajr, you will be. Allah said, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Make sure that you are in the time of the Salah, praying in Jama'ah in the Masjid. And stand up, قانتا لله. Invoking your Lord, supplicating to your Lord. Reciting the remembrance of your Lord, reciting the Quran, because the reward is great. It is reported in one of the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people of Jannah if they need anything extra after they enter the Jannah, if they need anything. So they will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, didn't you protected us from the punishment of hell? Didn't you allow us to enter al-Jannah and to enjoy everything in it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them something more. Allah azza wa jal will let them know that He is pleased with them, and He will never be angry at them. He will never test them again. It is life forever. And there is something extra. What is it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove hijab al-nur. There is a curtain from light. So Allah will remove it for the believers to be able to see Allah Azza wa Jal. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu went in the journey of al-Mi'raj, we all knew that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu went from sky to sky until he was above the seven heavens. Then Angel Jibreel took him until Sidrat al-Muntaha. Then After certain point, only Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was able to walk. Even Jibreel himself was not able to go walk with him. And Prophet Muhammad ﷺ spoke with Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah commanded him to inform the Muslims, the believers, that they are obligated to pray 5 times a day. We all knew the story, it was 50, ended with 5. With the reward of 50. See the generosity of Allah. So when Prophet Muhammad ﷺ came back, people asked him, did you see Allah? Because he was above everything. He was above the 7 heavens. You passed the Sidrat al-Muntaha. You passed the heaven, the level that Jibreel is able to arrive to. And you spoke to Allah Azza wa Jal without Jibreel. Did you see Allah? So the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wa salam, Ra'aytu nuran. I saw light. In another narration, he said, Nur. Anna ara. There was Nur, light. So how I see? So he didn't see, alayhi salatu wasalam. He saw by his heart. But he did not see by the eyes. Before entering Jannah, this eye will not be able to see. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about himself, La tudrikuhu al-absar. Wa huwa yudriku al-absar. So this created eye will not be able to see Allah in dunya. It is very weak. Allah is so great. So powerful. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This weak eye, this limited eye cannot see Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot hear Allah. Because it's limited. Everything you are given is just limited for dunya. But when you are in Jannah, the size is different. The power is different. When you are in Jannah, your eye is a reward. The power of your eye is a reward from Allah. So Allah will make your eyes able to see Him. So the believers will be able to see Allah every Friday in Jannah. Is there Friday prayer in Jannah? No, we don't pray in Jannah. In Jannah, there is no work. It is the break. It is the vacation. It is unlimited life without work. You work only in this limited time of 60, 70, 80 years. You work hard to build your future. After graduation with success, after we pass the test, after we enter Jannah, no more work. But the Friday will be a day that we come to see Allah. So the one of the believers, after he sees Allah on Friday and come back to his wives in his castles, they ask him, why you look more beautiful than the way when you left? When you left, you was beautiful, but now you are more beautiful. You are increased in beauty. So the believer will say, how come I'm not more beautiful? And I just came from seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you know that you will see Allah Azza wa Jal, is it worth it to get tired a little bit? Is it worth it to make sure that in time of Salah you are in the masjid? Is it worth it when it's time to give zakah you give it? Is it worth it when it's time of fasting you accept some hunger to be thirsty for a period of time? Is it worth it to make one trip to Hajj if you are able once in your lifetime? Is it worth it to be beautiful to your parents? Is it worth it to be good to your kin? To have a good kin relations? Is it worth it to stay away from haram and wrongdoing and evil thing? Is it worth it? Wallahi, it is worth it. Wallahi, it is worth it. When we do shirk, when we are kuffar, you know what's going to happen to us? Allah said in the Quran, clearly, kalla. إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون in سورة المطففين. Go look to the explanation of this verse. كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون ثم إنهم لصالوا الجحيم. So some people will be enjoying today. They don't want to give up their time. They want to enjoy every moment. They want to enjoy the enjoyment of dunya. They want the worldly gain. They look under their feet. So in the day of judgment, Allah said, nay. They will not be able to see Allah. It's a punishment. To be prevented from seeing Allah, it's a punishment. It is the worst punishment. And then they will be taken to hellfire without seeing their Lord who created them, Azza wa Jal. But the believers, because they were fair, they knew that Allah did create them, so none worthy of being worshipped except Him. He is the creator, so He is the one must be worshipped. He is the provider, the sustainer, so He is the one who must be praised and thanked and appreciated. It is not fair that Allah creates and we worship other than Him. It's not fair that Allah Azza wa Jal provides and we thank other than Him. And if we know that we are the worshippers of Allah, we must listen to Him. We are servants. We are slaves. If He said do, you have no say. If He said don't do, you have no say. You say سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. We heard and we obey, seeking your forgiveness. We know that we will be returned back to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you put in your mind that you are not created to enjoy this dunya, you are created to enjoy al-jannah. You are here in a trip like a stranger, passing by. And then after you pass the test, you are back home, al-jannah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam. He created Adam and allowed him to enter Jannah. Then when he did something wrong and got kicked out, for us to learn, when we disobey you, we will be kicked out. But you still have a chance to repent and come back. As long as you are still alive, you can repent and go back. Go back to Jannah. So when we die, when the believers die, they will see the angels of mercy in front of them, telling them no more fear. You will never grieve. In your grave, Allah will support you to answer the questions of the angels. In the resurrection day, you come out of your grave, the angels of Allah in your reception. They treat you like a VIP. And they take you to meet with your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam beside the river of Al-Kawthar. And don't ever invent something in the deen that is not from it. Because once we fabricate in the deen, we will not be able to arrive to our Prophet. Not only we will not be able to see Allah, we will not be able even to meet with the Prophet. When we fabricate deen, when we add and delete and edit and mix our personal opinions with the Sharia of Allah, no, even the Prophet, we will not be able to see him. But those who used to be upon the way of the Prophet والسلام, they only worship Allah by what Allah did legislate. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only by the guidance of Muhammad والسلام. They don't have any other sheikh. They don't have any other imam. They don't have any other religious leader. He is only one, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They look for his knowledge, for his practice. They believe in what he believed in, aqidah. And they act upon his way. So if you are like that, you will be able to go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beside the river of Al-Kawthar. He will give you from the water of this river, Al-Kawthar. So you will drink and you will never be thirsty at all after that. Then he will be with you in the day of judgment. When you are talking to Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will show you your deeds. He will show you the good deeds and the mistakes that you did and you repented from, and He forgave. He will show you. Allah will bring you close. Because you are a believer, He will make it a private conversation. The Prophet said in the Arabic language, فَيَضَعُكَ نَفَهُ عَلَيْهِ. That means Allah will cover him, so nobody will listen to the conversation. Allah will say, عَبْدِي أَتَذْكُرُ ذَنْبَ كَذَا أَتَذْكُرُ ذَنْبَ كَذَا. My servant, do you remember this sin that you committed? Do you remember this sin that you committed in this day, in this place? So the servant will say, أَذْكُرُ يَا رَبْ. I remember, my Lord, I remember. هَذَا فِي الصَّغَائِرِ وَالْعَبْدُ مِنَ الْكَبَائِرِ مُسْفِقٍ. He is only seeing the minor sins, and he is worried about the major ones that he's not seen yet. So Allah Azza wa Jal will tell him, as I covered you in dunya and nobody got to know about it, I will forgive it to you now. Go to Jannah. So this person will, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put his book in the scale and It is proved that his good deeds are more than his bad deeds. He will take the book by his right hand and run happy in front of everyone to tell people, ها أمقرأ كتابي. Read my book. See my record. See my the certificate of my graduation. ها أمقرأ كتابي. إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابي. I was thinking that I will be punished. Why he was thinking? Because he was humble. He was doing good and criticizing himself. Some people, they are doing bad and praising themselves. They do bad and defend themselves. They are eager only for dunya and they think that the Jannah will be gifted to them for free. But the believers, the real ones, they are doing their best to please Allah in dunya and they are criticizing themselves. And in the resurrection day, they will think that they will be punished. They will think that what they did will never enough. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will appease their hearts. So they will be able to cross the straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim, safely. The fire is under them, but they will be able to cross. Then the Prophet will take them to Jannah. To live in their houses, to drink from the rivers of Jannah, to drink from the halal khamr, from the halal laban, the laban of Jannah. They will eat from the fruits of Jannah. And everything they ask for, they will be given. And the most important thing that Allah will announce that He is pleased with them and He will never get angry at them. He will never will test them anymore. That's it. Forever. And then people will be able to see Allah Azza wa Jal. We're going to see what? You will see Allah the way He wants. The way, don't have imagination in your mind now. Whatever your brain is able to see is not the truth. Because this limited brain will never be able to imagine Allah. Allah is greater than your ability to imagine Him. Allah does not look like anything He created. So anything you are able to see, Allah is different. And anything you are able to imagine, Allah is different. So nothing in front of you looks like Allah, and nothing you can imagine is like Allah. كل ما خطر ببالك الله بخلاف ذلك ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Everything you are able to imagine, Allah is different. Nothing into like Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't be busy arguing. I will be seen a specific essence. You will see Allah as the way He wants. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He told you will be able to see me, believe that you'll be able to see Allah. This is the belief of Ahl Sunnah. Don't be among the people of Bid'ah, the sects of innovations. Don't follow them when they deny that the believers will be able to see Allah. When they say that Allah is not something to be seen, Allah will be seen. As He said in the Quran, He said that we will see Allah. It is a prize and reward for the believers. So be happy. It's a good news. And work for it. Work for it. Wallahi, if you work for it, you will get it. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك أتوب إليك. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله يحفظك.